Dating and Marriage. Dating and Marriage, The Good and the Ugly, Adam and Eve, Isaac and Rebecca, Jacob married Leah and Rachel, Boaz and Ruth, God brought the woman to man, Genesis 1:22. And God said to man, Therefore shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall join to his wife one, and they shall become one flesh, Genesis 1:24. After their union the serpent presented himself to Eve prompting her to eat of the forbidden fruit. Now the serpent said to the woman, Has God indeed said, You shall not eat of every tree of the garden? And the woman said to the serpent, We may eat of the fruit of the trees of the garden, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has says, You shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it, lest you die, Genesis 3:1-3. After Adam and Eve had eaten of the forbidden fruit, Genesis 3:6, their eyes were open, Genesis 3:7, to know good and evil, Genesis 3:22. God said to Eve, I will multiply your sorrow and conception. In pain you shall bring forth children. Your desire shall be to your husband, and he shall rule over you, Genesis 3:16. And to Adam God said, Because you have heeded to the voice of your wife, and have eaten of the tree, of which I commanded you, saying, You shall not eat, cursed is the ground for your sake. In toil shall you eat of it all the days of your life. In the sweat of your face shall you eat bread, until you return to the ground. Genesis 3:17-19. Therefore the Lord God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from which he was taken, Genesis 3:23. Do you believe this marriage was succeeding? Adam had been given the responsibility to lead his family. The woman was to be his helpmate, Genesis 1:18, only to assist him, not take the lead. Adam was right there with Eve as she was talking to the serpent, because after she had eaten of the fruit, she also gave to her husband with her, and he ate, Genesis 3:6. Please note that the word with denotes that Adam was in her presence when Satan tempted Eve to eat the forbidden fruit. Adam failed to guide and protect his wife by allowing her to eat the forbidden fruit and then eating it himself. Look at the final results of disobedience to God. Eve had to bear children with pain. Adam having to grow food by the seed of his brow. Adam and Eve cast out of the Garden of Paradise. Later Adam and Eve had two sons, Genesis 4:1, 2, Cain and Abel. They made an offering to God. Because God accepted the offering of Abel but God did not accept Cain's offering, Cain became jealous with anger toward Abel, Genesis 4:5, and murdered Abel, Genesis 4:8. Isaac and Rebekah, because Abraham was old and advanced in age, Genesis 24:1, he commanded his servant Eliezer, Genesis 15:2, Please, I will make you swear by the Lord. You will not take a wife for my son from the daughters of the Canaanites. But you shall go to my country and to my family, and take a wife for my son Isaac, Genesis 24 2-4. After Eliezer arrived in Mesopotamia, the city of Nabor, he asked God for a sign to indicate which woman God wanted Isaac to marry, Genesis 24, 10-24. God granted Eliezer his request, Genesis 24 15-20. Later Rebekah's brother and mother, Genesis 24:55, asked her if she would go with Eliezer to marry Isaac, someone she has never met, Genesis 24:58. Rebekah said, Yes. Rebekah married Isaac, Genesis 24:66. Notes, fathers selected a wife for their sons during biblical times. Abraham commissions his servant Eliezer to go to his hometown to select a wife for Isaac from among his kinsmen. Eliezer, a God-fearing man, asked God to select the right mate by providing him a sign. God chose Rebekah to be Isaac's wife, not Isaac. There was not any dating. This marriage was designed by God. Jacob married Leah and Rachel. Isaac commanded Jacob, You shall not take a wife from the daughters of Canaan. Take yourself a wife from the daughters of Laban your mother's brother, Genesis 28 1-2. After Jacob arrived in Haran, Rebekah's brother Laban's home place, Rachel came with Laban's sheep to water their sheep at the well where Jacob had just arrived, Genesis 29 1-10. Rachel's arrival at the well, Genesis 29 9, was similar to his mother Rebecca's arrival at the well when Abraham's servant Eliezer asked God for a sign for the selection of a mate for Isaac, Genesis 24:15-20. Jacob kissed Rachel and lifted up his voice and wept, Genesis 29:11. Jacob believed that this was a sign from God that Rachel was God's choice for him for a mate. Jacob served Laban for 7 years, Genesis 29:28, as a substitute for bride price to marry Rachel. But Jacob was deceived on the wedding night. He awakened the next morning and realized he had to marry Leah, Rachel's oldest sister, Genesis 29:23-25. Because of Jacob's love for Rachel, he agreed to serve for Laban another 7 years, Genesis 29:29. Note, Jacob believed that his meeting of Rachel at the well was a duplicate of his mother's meeting his father Isaac at the well. This was another marriage designed by God. Ruth, Boaz and Naomi, a marriage ordained by God through the acts of Naomi. Elimelech with his wife Naomi and two sons moved to Moab because of a famine in Judah, Ruth 1:1-2. Naomi's husband Elimelech died, Ruth 1:3. Naomi's two sons married Moab women, Ruth and Orpah, Ruth 1:4. Naomi's two sons died, Ruth 1:5, left two widows. Naomi returned to Judah in Bethlehem, Ruth 1:7-22, with Ruth who refused to leave Naomi, Ruth 1:16-17. Ruth found favor in Boaz's eyes. She asked him, "Why have I found favor in your eyes, that you should take notice of me, since I am a foreigner?" Ruth 2:10. Then Boaz answered and said to her, "It has been fully reported to me, all that you have done for your mother-in-law since the death of your husband. The Lord repay your work, and a full reward be given you by the Lord of Israel." Ruth 2:11-12. Because of Ruth's dedicated, unselfish act toward Naomi, Boaz knew God would reward Ruth. Naomi felt she was responsible for the security of Ruth, Ruth 3:1. Therefore Naomi directed Ruth to go down to the threshing floor. Notice the place where he lies. Uncover his feet, and lie down. And he will tell you what you should do, Ruth 3:2-4. And she, Ruth said to her, "Naomi, all that you say to me I will do," Ruth 3:5. After Ruth had done all that Naomi had told her to do, Boaz said, "Blessed are you of the Lord, my daughter. Do not fear. I will do for you all that you request, for all the people of my town know that you are a virtuous woman," Ruth 3:10-11. Boaz redeems Ruth and marries her, Ruth 4:1-13. Ruth bears a son by Boaz called Obed, Ruth 4:13. Obed begot Jesse, and Jesse begot David, Ruth 4:22. This genealogy leads to the birth of Jesus Christ, Matthew 1:1-16. Dating summary, there is no such thing as dating during biblical times. Dating is a modern idea started by this worldly system.